Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Facebook yoga this evening.
Yoga with the animals.
I hope you've had a good day. The weather hasn't been great. In fact, it's been damn cold, but I haven't been outside all day. I've just been sitting cozily by the fire, so it's been okay. This evening I was going to do a class focused on balance, but I've just been feeling really like I just want to do some relaxing and comforting chilled out yoga. So that is what we're going to do this evening instead of the balance session I had planned, and we'll do the balance session on another day. So we have my lovely mother, Mum
Evening.
Jenny, joining us. We have the usual animals. Caffrey is here as always. She's very impressed with the setup that we've got here for the yoga this evening. Whoop! Hopefully she's going to be well behaved. Okay, so we've got a lovely setup here. I've put some sleeping bags down on the floor underneath our yoga mat so that we're on the cold tiled floor so that we can be nice and cozy. We've got the fire going and we're right in front of the fire. So it's again lovely and warm. Hi Charlotte, hi DL, lovely to see you watching. Gypsy, Gypsy's not very chilled at the moment, as you can see. Gypsy wants to play, but she's gonna chill out in a minute. She thinks because I'm on the floor that that means it's playtime, but it's not. Okay, so we also, me and my mum, we both put our pyjamas on and I've got my nice cozy hoodie on. So I'm ready to do a nice super chilled yoga session this evening. So if you don't have a mat, then you can improvise. Gypsy, no. Maybe you could do like I've done. I've put a couple of sleeping bags out on the floor. You could use a rug, a towel. I do apologise for my dog. I'm gonna... Gypsy, calm down. Calm. Good girl. Good girl. She's actually doing what I say. It's not going to last very long. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to come to a seated position. If you're comfortable sitting on the floor, you can sit on the floor with your legs either in a cross leg position or straight out in front of you, however you feel most comfortable. If you would prefer to sit on a cushion, as my mum is doing, more comfortable on a cushion, then please feel free to sit on a cushion. Just make yourself comfortable. We're going to be seated for quite a while. We're not even going to come up to a standing position in today's yoga session. So we're going to either be sitting or laying. So make yourself comfortable. Okay, and right, Gypsy, calm. So first of all, we're just going to start off by sitting comfortably. Sitting with our back straight. Our shoulders back and our chest forwards. And close our eyes. And we're just going to begin by noticing our breath. Not trying to change your breathing at the moment. Just noticing your breath. The sensation of breathing. Your in-breath, your out-breath. And also, just notice how you're feeling this evening. Notice your emotions, your state of mind. But do so in a non-judgmental way. So don't have emotions about your emotions. Just notice how you're feeling. Be comfortable with how you're feeling. Just sit with your emotions. Sit with your breath. Enjoy the feeling of breathing. Okay, to open the session this evening, I would love you to join me in chanting Om 6 times. This allows us to connect the world with our breath, to calm and to focus our minds. Breathing in through your nose. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Okay, remaining with your eyes closed, sitting with your back straight, we're going to breathe slowly and deeply. Using our abdomen as well as our chest. So as you inhale slowly. And as you're inhaling, let your stomach, your tummy come out. As your diaphragm pushes down, pushes your internal organs, your abdominal organs down and out. Let your chest expand, the intercostal muscles, the muscles in between your ribs stretch. Allowing your body to create space in your chest for your lungs to fully expand. And as you exhale, really draw your abdomen in, engaging your stomach muscles, pull your belly button towards your spine. Let your chest contract, your shoulders relax. Try to exhale as completely as you can. Follow your breath as it enters your body. Move your nostrils over the back of your throat. Notice how cool the air feels as it passes over the back of your throat when you inhale. And then when you exhale, notice how much warmer the air is over the back of your throat. Notice as it passes again through your nostrils, the warmth of your breath on your upper lip. Enjoy the sensation of breathing. Feel gratitude as the air enters and fills your lungs. As you exhale, imagine that you are exhaling any stress, any anxiety that you may be feeling. Release it, let it go. Use your breath to come into the present moment. The only moment that exists. Okay, returning to your natural breath, your normal breath, not trying to change your breathing. This evening is going to be a very relaxed practice, so if you feel that you would like to keep your eyes closed, semi-closed, as we're practicing the relaxing asanas, as we're moving our body in a relaxed way, then that can have a really calming influence. And remember that we want to move as much as possible with our breath. So we're going to start off, we're going to stay in a seated position. So just make sure that you're comfortable. If you want to shift position, then please do so. Make sure that you are comfortable. We're going to start off by stretching our neck. So as I said, it's nice to do this keeping your eyes closed. We're going to move with our breath. So first of all, we're going to exhale and look down to our laps, bringing your chin down towards your chest. And then we're going to inhale and bring our head back to look up at the ceiling, or to face the ceiling. And then we're going to exhale and again look down to our laps. Inhale, bring your head back so you're facing the ceiling. Keep on going at your pace with your breath. Slow movement, slow breath. Now bringing your head back to center, back to a neutral position. We're going to turn our head from side to side. Again, moving with your breath. Inhale and exhale. Turn your head to the right to look over your right shoulder. Inhale, back to the front, exhale, to the left, inhale, front, exhale, right. Again, keep on moving at your pace with your breath. Slow movement, slow breath. Being really mindful, really aware of how your neck feels, how your shoulders feel as you're turning your head. Notice any areas of stiffness or discomfort. Notice any asymmetries between the two sides of your body. Okay, now returning your head back to center. We're going to tilt our head from side to side, slowly, in a controlled way, with our breath. Inhale and exhale, tilt your head to the right side. Bringing your right ear down to your right shoulder, but keeping your right shoulder down. Now back to the center. Exhale to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, right. Again, keep going at your pace with your breath. And again, now bring your head back to center. We're going to roll our heads, a couple of rolls in each direction. So we're going to look down to our lap. We're going to slowly, very slowly, in a controlled way, bring our right ear around to our right shoulder. Bring our head back to look up at the ceiling. Left ear to left shoulder. And back to look at our laps again. Back the other way now. Left ear to left shoulder. All the way around. And then just slowly once more in each direction. Now let's just roll our shoulders backwards. So lifting them up towards your ears, then pulling them back, pulling your shoulder blades together. Nice big rolls. And forwards. Now bringing your arms out in front of you at about shoulder level. Palms facing down to the floor. We're going to make a fist as tight as we can. We're going to open our hands, our fingers, as much as we can. Close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open. Good. Now flexing the wrist up and down. Yeah. with your fists, trying to move both your fists in the same direction. And then back in the other direction. And then mirroring each other. And back in the other direction. Good. Okay, now we're going to bring our legs out in front of us so that they're straight. Try to sit up as tall as you can. And we're going to just get our hip moving a little bit. Well, I want you to just bend your right knee and hold on underneath your right thigh, just behind your knee. Lift your foot up off of the floor. We're going to bring our knee in close towards our body. Keep on supporting your leg now as you straighten your leg out, trying to keep your heel away from the floor. Bend your knee and try to move with your breath. So we're going to inhale, bend, exhale, straighten. Inhale, bend, exhale, straighten. Two more, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Good. Place your right leg back down again. I'm going to do the same thing with the left. So again, bending your knee, supporting your leg by holding on around the back of your left thigh, just behind the knee. Straighten as you exhale. Inhale, bend your knee. Exhale, straighten. Inhale, bend. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale, exhale, last one. Inhale, exhale. Good, excellent. Now again, we're going to do a stretch for the hip, for the knee, and for the ankle. It's called half butterfly. So we're going to keep our left leg straight and we're going to bend our right leg. Depending on the flexibility of your hip and your knee, we can either place the sole of your right foot on the inside of your left thigh. If you can, you can bring your right foot onto your left thigh with the sole of your foot facing upwards. We're going to support our right foot, with our left hand, and we're going to use our right hand to hold our knee. And we're just going to slowly and gently move our knee up and then push it down towards the floor. Again, we're going to do it with our breath. So we're going to inhale up, exhale down. Just gently. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Couple more, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. We're going to bend our left leg now. Again, either bring the sole of your left foot onto the inside of your right thigh, or if you are able, bring your left foot on to your right thigh. Supporting your left foot with your right hand, use your left hand to move your knee gently up and down. With your breath, inhale up, exhale down. I'm stroking the cat as I do this move. She's enjoying that. Catherine, she has a name. Yoga's better with animals, I think. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Couple more. Good, okay. Now we're going to practice full butterfly, just gently. We're going to bring the soles of our feet together. And we're going to try to bring our heels in close to our perineum. And try to bring our knees down towards the floor. This is a really good stretch for our hips. Now, we're going to hold on to either our feet or our ankles. So if you can, interlock your fingers around your feet and pull yourself up so you're sitting straight. Or alternatively, you can hold on around your ankles and then do the same thing. Try to pull yourself up straight so you're sitting tall. And you can feel that stretch then there, also in your shoulders and your upper back. And breathe slowly and deeply. Close your eyes. Good. And release. Okay, one last stretch in the seated position before we shift to position. Probably getting a little bit uncomfortable sitting on the floor now. What we're going to do is we're going to sit resting with our legs straight out in front of us, resting on our hands. So we've got our palms flat. However you feel comfortable, either with your fingers pointing backwards or facing forwards, however you feel most comfortable. And we're just going to flex our ankles. So we're going to bring, first of all, we'll try to bring our toes back towards our knees. And then we're going to point our toes, trying to bring our toes down as close as we can to the mat. Again, moving with your breath. Inhale, bring your toes back. Exhale, point your toes down to the floor. Inhale. Exhale, point your toes. Inhale. Exhale. Keep on moving your feet with your breath at your pace. Okay, now bring your feet slightly further apart. We're going to rotate our ankles. So we're going to imagine that we're drawing circles with our big toe. Try to make those circles as big as you can. And back the other way. give your legs a little bit of a shake. Walk them from side to side. And now we're going to come to a kneeling position into tabletop position. In fact, actually, no, we're going to come to a kneeling position first of all. If you can comfortably kneel, then come to kneel so that you're sitting with your bottom on your heels. If you find that uncomfortable, then you can sit on your cushion. The idea is that we want our bottom raised up a little bit. Okay, we're going to do a seated version of cat-cow. Really opening up the body as we inhale and then curling in on ourselves as we exhale. So what we're going to do is we're going to inhale, open our arms right out. We're going to push our chest and our abdomen forward and look up towards the ceiling. Really opening up your chest. And then we're going to exhale and we're going to curl forwards, tucking your head down towards your chest, wrapping your arms around you and giving yourself a nice hug. Inhale, open, out. Exhale, curl in on yourself. Inhale, really open up. Exhale, close. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Now coming back to a neutral position. Now we're going to come onto all fours into tabletop position. So remember position directly underneath your shoulders, about shoulder width apart. Your knees directly underneath your hips, about hip distance apart. If you do have any problems with your wrists, if it feels very uncomfortable for you to rest on your hands in this way, then you can move your hands slightly further forward. That takes direct pressure off of your wrist. And we're going to practice the cat-cow stretch. So again, we're going to be moving with our breath. We're going to do your version of it straight away afterwards. I don't know if you want to.
Okay,
so we're going to start off. We're going to inhale. And we're going to exhale and round our back up towards the ceiling, tucking our head under to look at our belly button like a cat stretching. Inhale, we're going to look up towards the ceiling, dipping our belly down, bringing our hips up to the ceiling also. Exhale. To cat, really arching your back, tucking your head under. Inhale to cow, really dipping your belly down, bringing your head up, your hips up. Keep on moving with your breath at your pace. Making the breath last the length of the movement. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Do the movement with your eyes closed. It's nice and relaxing. Just feel your body moving. Okay, now we're going to practice a similar flow between asanas, but rather than flowing between cat and cow, we're going to flow between child's pose and cow. So we're going to inhale and come to cow, looking up at the ceiling, bringing your hips, your sit bones up to the ceiling and dipping your belly. Then we're going to exhale and bring our bottom back to our heels. Our forehead down to the mat into extended child's pose. And then we're going to inhale and flow back to again. Exhale, flow back to extended child's pose. Inhale, cow. Again, keep on going at your pace. Slow breath, slow movement. The next time you come back to extended child's pose, just rest there, taking some deep breaths. And now shifting yourself back to tabletop position. We're now just going to practice puppy pose. So keeping your hips above your knees, we're going to walk our hands forward, keeping our arms straight, about shoulder width apart. And we're going to bring our forehead down towards the mat. You can place a cushion underneath your forehead. You see what my mom is doing there. She is placing a folded blanket underneath her forehead. If you can't bring your forehead down to the mat, you can support yourself in that way. Feel the stretch in your shoulders, your side body, your upper back. Breathe slowly and deeply. Close your eyes. Sliding them back so you can push yourself back up. Now we're slowly going to come down onto our mats, on our tummies. And we're going to start off with Sphinx position. So Sphinx position, remember we're going to have our elbows directly under, our arms forward about shoulder width apart, parallel with each other. So if you are on a mat, you can use the size of your mat to check whether your arms are coming straight forward. Spread the fingers on your hands and push your palms into the floor. It's just a small movement to come into Sphinx pose. You should feel your lower back muscles engaging, a stretch across the front of your chest. We're going to inhale and look up to the ceiling, pushing our chest forward. And exhale, relax. We're going to do that a couple more times. Inhale slowly, look up, push your chest forward. Exhale, relax, bring your head back down. Once more, inhale, look up, push your chest forward, and exhale, relax, exhale, collapse. Okay, next we're going to practice a pose. A restorative pose called fallen tree pose. Okay, so tree pose is when we're standing, is when we bring the sole of our foot onto the inside of the other leg. So we're going to do that in a laying position, a lying position. So let's start with our right leg. If you just bend your right leg, so that you're bringing the sole of your foot, it can be at any point on your leg. Is there a cat in the way?
There's a cat.
It can be at any point on your leg, wherever you feel comfortable. So it might be that the sole of your right foot is just resting the inside of your ankle, the inside of your calf. Maybe you want to bring it up a little bit higher so it's on the inside of your thigh. Try to keep your pelvis as square as possible, so we're not really turned to the side too much, so that we're getting a nice gentle stretch there in our groin. And we're going to, with our arms, we're just going to cross our arms so that our fingertips come to our elbows, and we're just going to rest our forehead on our wrists. Try to rest that point in between your eyebrows on your wrist bone. That's a pressure point, so if you push into that point, that's very relaxing. And just breathe slowly and deeply. Feel your tummy pushing into the floor as you inhale. Okay, now we're going to change side, shift our position. So we're going to straighten our right leg and bend our left leg.
You all right?
You're cramped.
Cramping me back.
Just massage my mom's butt. Okay, and again, just breathe.
chin, your forehead, to your wrists. Close your eyes, breathe deeply, relax.
Now straighten your left leg, bringing your legs together.
And just rest for a few moments more in crocodile pose,
which is where we have our arms crossed, our fingertips coming to our elbows and our forehead resting on our wrists. Okay, now placing your palms down so that you can push yourself up slowly. We're going to come again to a seated position. We're not going to be in a seated position for long. In a minute, we're going to lay down on our backs. But before we do that, I just want you to come into cosmic egg pose. So we're going to bend our knees and hug our knees in towards our body, trying to keep your back straight. So you're drawing your shoulders back, pushing your chest forwards. And then we're just going to try to balance on our bottom. So just bring our feet just slightly off of the floor. Again, just breathing slowly and deeply. It's a simple position, but you should really feel your core muscles engaging to keep you steady. Good, okay, and bringing your feet back down to the mat. Release your hands. And now we're going to come and lay on our backs on the mat. My mum has a cat in the way. I'm just going to have to shift her. Oh, and she got your pillow.
Yeah. Come on, Katharina. Right.
Okay, so laying on your back. Now, keeping your left leg straight, we're going to hug our right knee in towards our body. Okay, so wrapping both arms around your right shin. Your head should be on the floor, on the mat. Just pull your thigh in towards your abdomen. Now bringing your head up, try to bring your nose towards your knee. It doesn't need to be anywhere near your knee, don't worry about that, just towards your knee. Okay, and now, see if you can take your right hand and hold on to the outside of your right foot. Trying to keep your knee bent, try to pull your knee in towards your elbow. Good, and then see if you can bring your head down to the mat.
You've got yours the other side.
That's it, that side. Good, this is called half happy baby pose. And release, relax. Okay, that's going to be the hardest thing we do all session, don't worry. Okay, now with your left knee, we're going to bend our left knee and wrapping our arms around our left shin, hug your knee in towards your body, bringing your head back down to the mat. Remembering all the time to breathe slowly and deeply. And now we're going to raise our head, try to bring our nose towards our left knee. Again, remember it doesn't matter if you're nowhere near your knee, just towards your knee. And now reaching for the outside of your left foot with your left hand. Bring your knee towards your elbow, towards your armpit. Half happy baby. If you can, bring your head back down to the mat. If not, you can keep your head up. Good. And release. Now we're going to hug both of our knees in towards our chest, wrapping our arms around both shins. Try to bring your head back down to the mat. And if you would like, you can rock slowly from side to side, giving your spine a massage. And relax, release your legs, bring your feet down to the mat. Keep your knees bent and bring your feet the width of the mat. So if you haven't got a mat, just your feet just slightly wider than your hips. Going to bring our arms out at shoulder level, with our palms facing down towards the floor. We're going to practice something called windscreen wiper. So we're going to inhale and exhale, lower your knees, both of your knees to the floor, towards the floor on the right side, and turn your head to look at your left hand. Inhale, bring your knees back to center. Exhale, your knees to the floor. On the left side, turn your head to look at your right hand. So your knees look a little bit like the windscreen wipers on your car. Inhale back to the center. Exhale to the right, turning your head to look at your left hand. Again, keep on going at your pace with your breath. Inhaling to the center, exhaling to the side. Slow movement, slow breath. Good, and coming back to center again. Now leaving your feet on the floor again, your knees bent, your feet about the width of the mat, your heels nice and close in towards your bottom. We're going to bring our arms by our side with our palms facing down to the floor. We're going to inhale and lift our bottom up away from the mat, pushing our hips towards the ceiling, peeling your spine away from the mat, up onto our shoulders. Exhale, we're going to slowly lower, bringing our bottom back down to the floor. Inhale, lift. Really pushing your hips up towards the ceiling. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. One more. Okay, now bringing your legs straight. We are going to walk our feet over towards the right side, keeping your bottom where it is, and cross your left ankle over your right ankle. Bring your arms up overhead, and we're going to bring our arms over towards the right side, also taking hold of your right wrist with your left hand. So your bottom should be staying where it is, so we're coming into like a banana shape, and hold. And relax your arms, walk your legs back to the center, and we're going to go to the other side. So walk your heels over towards the left side, cross your right ankle over your left ankle, and then bringing arms back up overhead, straight walk, or bring your arms over to the left side, holding on to your left wrist with your right hand. And again, just hold. And relax. Okay, one last stretch, one last asana before we take Savasana. So we're going to practice revolved abdomen if there wasn't a cat in the way. So again, bringing your arms out to about shoulder level with your palms facing down.
Sorry, Catherine, you're just going to have to move just a minute.
There we go. And we're going to... Sorry, this is moving the cat. We're going to inhale, bring our knees towards our chest. And exhale, bring our knees down towards the floor on the right side and turn our head to look at our left hand. Try to keep your shoulders on the floor. Inhale, bring your knees back to the center. Exhale your knees to the floor on the left side, turning your head to look at your right hand. Again, trying to keep your shoulders to the floor. Inhale back to the center, once more to each side. Exhale to the right. Inhale to the center, exhale to the left. And then inhale back to the center. Exhale your feet down to the floor, relax. Okay, now it's time for Savasana. So we're going to make ourselves comfortable, make sure that we're warm. So if you want to put any jumpers back on that you've taken off, if you want to put socks on, if you want to put a blanket over you, then please do so. I'm just going to give you a bit of a guided relaxation at the beginning of this Savasana, and then I will leave you to relax, and then we'll come into a short period of meditation at the end of the session. So laying on your back on the floor, bringing your feet slightly apart so that they're coming towards the corners of your mat. Your arms should be side, the palms facing up to the ceiling. Close your eyes. Take a long, slow, deep breath in. Hold your breath for a moment and then slowly exhale. Allow any tension to melt away as you gradually relax more and more deeply with each breath. Take another long, slow, deep breath in.
into your lungs completely. Take a third deep breath in. Take your time. Hold it for a moment. And then let it go. Already you're beginning to drift into a state of deep relaxation. Continue to breathe slowly and gently. Relax. Now bring your awareness to the top of your head. Imagine a feeling of relaxation beginning to spread down from the top of your scalp. Let the muscles in your forehead and your temples relax. Allow your eyes to relax. Let your cheeks and your jaw soften. Let go of all tension. Now imagine this peaceful feeling flowing down your neck and deep into the muscles of your shoulders, soothing them, releasing them. Allow this peaceful feeling to flow through your arms, relaxing and soothing all the way to the tips of your fingers. As your body relaxes, your mind relaxes. Your thoughts become weightless, like wisps of clouds on the breeze. Now the peaceful sensation flows through your chest and your stomach. Feel this area gently rising and falling as you breathe slowly and deeply, soothing and relaxing. Turn your attention to your back and feel this relaxing sensation flowing all the way down your spine. Now the peaceful feeling flows through your lower body. Relax your buttocks, the backs of your thighs, the front of these large, strong muscles becoming loose and relaxed. Soothing feelings flow down through your knees and into your calves. Your ankles relax. Now your feet relax. Your entire body is soft, calm, and relaxed. You are completely relaxed. her back to your body. Start to move your fingers and your toes. Bring your legs together. Reach your arms up overhead. And stretch, pointing your toes, trying to make your body as long as you can. And now relax your arms. Bend your knees. And keeping your eyes closed, roll slowly to the side. And rest on your side for a few moments. And then trying to keep your eyes closed, semi-closed, keep your mind relaxed. Push yourself up to a seated position. Sit comfortably, either on the floor or on your cushion. We're just going to spend a couple of minutes sitting and focusing on our breath, our natural breath. Sitting with your back straight, your eyes closed. Notice your in-breath, your out-breath. Again, just notice how you're feeling. Notice how your body is feeling. Notice how your mind is feeling. Notice your emotions. Notice if you feel different at the end of our practice today compared with how you felt at the beginning. And remember, any time you're feeling stressed, anxious, during this time, you can always come back to your breath. Remember that although we can't control what is happening to us or what is happening in the world, we can control how we respond to it. Use this time to practice being in the present moment, to take joy in the present moment.
take joy in your breath. We're just going to finish the session today by chanting Om three times, followed by Shanti, 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 peace, peace, peace. Inhale through your nose. Thank you very much, everybody who joined me this evening. I hope that you have a good evening. And I hope if you're off to eat your dinner right now that you have a lovely dinner. Bon appetit. And I hope you have a good night's sleep tonight and a brilliant day tomorrow. And love you all. Hope you're all well. Take care of yourself. Stay safe and sane. Bye.